On behalf of my beloved grandmother, Helen, I am truly honored to stand here in representation of all of the grandchildren, Judd, Chad, Jared, Adrian, and Christopher, and her four great-grandchildren. I want to start by setting the record straight in the room of all of these witnesses. I want especially my brother and Chad to know that I am the favorite. And as evidenced by the fact I never got a spanking with the house slipper, those two got all the spankings. Granddad never spanked me. Grandma never spanked me. I am the favorite. In all seriousness, she loved us each fiercely and uniquely. She made each and every one of us feel like we were her absolute favorite. Judd and Chad and I have wonderful, wonderful memories of our summers spent in Cincinnati at 3930 West Park Drive. And so I'm again just honored to be here. I wanted to share a few life lessons and stories with you all today. As my dad so eloquently said, my grandmother was a star in the community, and as such, she never left the house without looking like a star. I have never in my life seen my grandmother in jeans. She never left that house without wearing earrings, without putting slacks on, or in the summer, maybe shorts, but that was usually around the house. Because after all, she always told me, you never know who you're going to see out. And when we went out with my grandmother for hour-long trips to that grocery store, oh my gosh, Judd and Chad can tell you, she would drag us to this store called Biggs, which is kind of like Costco and Sam's, and we would go up and down every aisle, and she never met a stranger. So by the time we left, we were best friends with the cashier. Friends with the person who was bagging the groceries. That was just who she was. We never went to the grocery store without spending hours. And so you had to dress the part. You needed to be ready. And so that's something I still try to carry out this day. I don't accomplish it as well as she did, but she never left that house without looking like the star that she is. My second life lesson is that when I became of age and I started dating, she would always tell me, now Amber J is what she called me. So Amber J, good looks are nice, but you make sure you find the smartest nerd that you possibly can. He happens to be very handsome, and she did the same. She found two of the most handsome husbands and the most nerdiest husband. I mean, it doesn't get more nerdier than a civil engineer and a civil rights attorney, right?
Can you give back?
That's right.
So the third life lesson, Judd and I had a really long conversation. We've had long conversations about this as of recent, and Grandma's house, her telephone, was always a safe place and always a refuge for her grandchildren especially. You could call my grandmother at 3 a.m, and she would answer that phone as if it was new. Hello, Amber J, how are you? She never passed judgment. You may get an, oh dear, I've never heard that before. Oh my, that sounds serious. But she never passed judgment on us. You could tell her anything about anybody, and she was always there to listen to you. Her house was a safe place. I have wonderful memories of her hosting her couples club bridge parties, the ladies bridge party. Her house was a safe place, a refuge for everyone to come, to hang out, to have fun, to laugh, to joke, to tell stories. I have wonderful memories of my childhood, of gathering around her kitchen table at 3930 West Park Drive and staying up for hours and just laughing and talking and being with your family. I want to end by letting her grandchildren know, and it took my oldest daughter, Mia, to really remind me of this. I was sharing with Mia the other day that I was very sad and then I missed my grandmother terribly. And Mia told me, Mommy, she's always in your heart. And so to her grandchildren, no one can ever take your memories of her away. Although she's not with us in body, she's with us in our hearts, and she's here in spirit. Thank you.